In this presentation, we will learn how to declare an array of structure. So let's get started. Instead of declaring multiple variables, we can also declare an array of structure in which each element of the array will represent a structure variable. So in C, we are allowed to create an array of structure in which each element of the array will represent a structure variable. Okay, so we are creating basically an array of that structure type, and here each element of the array will represent a structure variable. Let's consider an example through a live running code. Okay, here in this example, we can see we have a structure car which consists of three members: fuel tank capacity, seating capacity, and city mileage. Right, within this main function, we have an array of type struct car which can accommodate up to two members, which means that we are creating two variables of type struct car. Okay, this is the easiest way to remember this. And this for loop will run from 0 to 1, right? Because I is initialized to 0, and here I must be less than 2, which means that this loop will run 2 times, right? With the help of this printf function, we are asking the user to enter the car 1 fuel tank capacity, right? Here percentage %d will get replaced by I plus 1. I is 0 initially, therefore it will get replaced by 1. So it is asking the user to enter the car 1 fuel tank capacity. Here what the user will enter will get stored in the ci.fuelTankCapacity, right? When I is 0, it is replaced by 0. Then it becomes c0.fuelTankCapacity, right? And here we will ask the user to enter car 1 sitting capacity also. And we are asking the user to enter the car 1 city mileage, right? Please remember in this case that we are expecting a float value from the user when we are asking a city mileage, okay? Now, after the user input, we will print all the details on the screen. Here in this case, the car details we are printing. Obviously, first we will print the car 1 details, then we will print the car 2 details. And each and every time we are printing fuel tank capacity, seating capacity, and city mileage. Okay, now let me execute this code and see what happens. Here it is asking to enter the car 1 fuel tank capacity. Let's say it is 23. Now it is asking us to enter the car 1 sitting capacity. Now it is asking us to enter the car 1 city mileage. Now it is asking us to enter the car 2 fuel tank capacity. Similarly, we will enter the rest of the details. These are all the details which are printed on the screen: car 1 details and car 2 details. Car 1 details are fuel tank capacity 23, seating capacity 5, city mileage 17.889999. Car 2 details are fuel tank capacity 22, seating capacity 7, city mileage is 14.650000. I hope this concept of creating an array of structure type is now clear to you. Okay friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.